Welcome back to Tagata Pasifika. Tuvalu is in the grip of a severe drought that's threatening lives and livelihoods.
The New Zealand government sent relief supplies and locals fear that unless rain comes soon, the outlook for this atoll community is very grim. Marama Papau has the story.
No rain for months has left its mark on Tuvalu's main island of Funafuti, and it's having an impact on its people.
It's not so good for us, for the living.
No water, no rain, it's so affected our life.
The New Zealand government is helping, sending supplies and having army personnel set up a plant that turns seawater into drinking water, although not in large enough amounts.
It was and still is pretty dire. The household allocation is 40 litres per household per day. Some households have two people, some households have 19 people. So when you're talking about small children, older folks, the water allocation is pretty poor.
While the situation on Funafuti is bad, on the outer islands the outlook is worse, and is why Tuvalu declared a state of emergency late last month.
Nukulaila was really bad. Now the trees were dying and then there was no water, there's no underground water, and there's very limited reserves of fresh water there. So we had to respond. But at the same time, you know, Funafuti, this island was all in bad shape, and so is the other seven islands north.
The drought is having an impact on the most vulnerable, as children succumb to heat exhaustion made worse by the rationing of drinking water.
You know, we buffer seawater, there's no water, we also lack of water. With the sun so hot, it's very hot. Without water, we can't drink very nicely because we budget our water.
At the same time, schools are doing their best to cope with thirsty children. Absenteeism is up and changes made to the school day.
I advise the teachers not to let the students out. For the first 15 minutes at the break time, they will go out and buy all their foods. The second bell, all the students should be inside the classroom and the teachers will organise something for them. The idea is not for the students not to expose to the sun.
If the drought worsens, schools are likely to reduce hours or even close. Meanwhile, the government is grateful for New Zealand's help and the assistance of other international agencies.
We don't have the capacity to recover any. I mean, if we are going like this without any rain for another, if we had continued without any assistance so far from New Zealand now, we'd be in real trouble, I think.
The New Zealand Army is doing its best to help, knowing there's really only one way to fix this problem.
We need rain. That would be the gold-plated solution.
Something these people need badly.